Assalamu alaikum and good morning in Bangladesh and good afternoon in Japan. So this is Shafiul Islam from Tohoku University. So today I'm going to talk about in chapter 4, the RC framework machine field on behalf of working group 2 activity in Tohoku University, PWD and Asuna University of Science and Technology. So first of all, a machine field RC building is very common starting system in developing countries and also in Bangladesh. So when we design this building, we consider the bare frame, but in reality, we input the machine field as a partition wall and also periphery wall. And also it is considered as non-structural wall. But what happened if earthquake damage? So this is observed past earthquake damage in different developing countries, for example, Nepal earthquake. And we can see based on observed damage and also past experiment, we can see there is some influence of mesh infill for seismic capacity improvement. And CNCRP, we are now adopting CNCRP manual as a seismic evaluation standard for evaluating of existing building in Bangladesh. In Dhaka, in Bangladesh, and still there are some special issues addressed in this CNCP manual, and it requires the further study. And among them, the mesh infill is one of them to be studied in the active sweep projects. And then I would like to talk about what is the benefit of mesh infill. Mesh infill improved can completely change the seismic capacity. It improves the strength and also stiffness. And considering it will reducing some ductility, but eventually improved the seismic index that I already explained in the previous presentation. So now it is required how to estimate the strength and ductility. I'm going to talk about in the following slide. So chapter four, this is the table of content of the chapter four. First of all, 4.1 in general, 4.2 classification of mesh infill walls and judgment criteria, and followed by strength index and ductility index and stiffness evaluation. And there is application example for understanding the calculation procedure and appendix. So this is the overall flow of the procedure. First of all, we will select RC frame with mesh infill. Then we try to classify this mesh infill is structural or non-structural elements. And if it is non-structural elements, we'll go directly out of plane failure, and then we'll check it is required or not, then we'll continue. And if it is structural element, then we will go judgment of failure mode first, and then we'll calculate the strength index, and then we will evaluate the ductility index, and we'll check the out of plane failure. And if out of plane failure is occurred, then we'll recommend retrofit design. And if it is not, then we'll use as a structural element of the mesh infill. So this is the overall flow of the procedure in chapter two. So now, first of all, classification of the classification into a structural wall or non-structural wall. So here only two, the several conditions. Here I'm going to talk about two conditions. This RC mesh infill should be confined with RC columns and also beams. And also here another condition is the height of infill and thickness should be less than 30. And in case of opening, here opening area is if it is less than 40% of the panel area, we can consider as a structural element. And also if length of mesh infill is 30% of the length of length of opening is 30% of the length of infill, then we can consider as a structural element. And another point is the opening should be in the center in this at this time. And these types of opening, we are not thinking to consider in the manual, but in the future research we can do for the further study to be considered as a structural element. And another point is at this time we are thinking the mesh infill should be in solid bricks. So hollow blocks and hollow concrete block may not be, cannot be considered in this manual. And then section 4.3, the identification of the failure mode. So here are four distinct failure modes we observed based on current study, experiment research, and also the previous study. First of all, diagonal compression failure. Here, diagonal compression failure, the mainstream field failed by diagonal compression. And here, hinge is formed in column and both column, top and bottom. And type two is sliding and diagonal cracking failure. And here also, mainstream infill sliding and also cracking failure is occurred and observed. And also the hinge is formed in top and bottom of the columns. And another types of failure is overall flexural failure. And this failure is mainstream infill wall acting cantilever RC wall. And another failure type four, column punching and joint sliding failure. And here column is punched at the beam column joint, and also the joint sliding failure observed at the joint between beams and also masonry infill. So this four distinct failure mode is observed based on this study, and we input in our manual. And now how to evaluate these failure modes? So first of all, we have two conditions. First of all, one condition is relative strength of RC frame to mainstream field. Here we are calling beta index. So beta index is the ratio of the lateral strength of columns and infill lateral strength of mainstream field. So based on beta index, we divide, we make some judgment criteria. If beta index is larger than one, we can say that this mainstream infill is good confinement and type one. And if it is beta index is 0.221, then we can consider it's poor confinement, then type two. And if it is less than 0.2, then it is very poor confinement, then we consider type three and four. So another criteria is we can calculate the contact length ratio, contact length and also column height. And here we can use this equation. I'm not going to discuss in detail. In our manual, we discussed how to calculate this contact length ratio. And here also we propose some judgment criteria, how to divide this failure mode based on contact length ratio. And this is the matrix based on different types of failure mode, depending on the beta index and also the contact length ratio with different types of failure, like shear types and freezer types, failure of the column. And now strength index. In strength index, we are thinking, considering RC frame with mainstream infill together. And here, strength index already discussed in the previous presentation. So here we are thinking the strength index CMW is the total lateral force is normalized by total building weight. And lateral strength of mainstream infill, here we are considering three equations. First of all, Q frame and Q infill for type one and type two, and QFW for type three, and QJW is type four. So type one and type two failure mode, here QMW is the summation of Q frame plus Q infill. Here Q frame is the summation of Q left, Q column left and Q column right, and here Q infill is the lateral strength of mainstream infill wall. Here we are Q diagonal and Q sliding. So type one diagonal compression failure, here we will calculate the Q diagonal by using these two equations depending on beta index and also contact length ratio. And type two, sliding and diagonal cracking failure, it is also skew slide will calculate by using this equation. And also we put those equations in section 4.4.2 and section 4.4.3 in the manual. And another two types failure mode, types three and type four, we'll consider overall flexural failure. Here QFW, we will calculate by using these equations. And column punching and joint sliding failure also we discussed in section 4.4.5. And then ductility index. Ductility index also we considered together RC frame with masonry infill as a unit. And here, this ductility index also we proposed some values based on the experiment and also the discussion with among our teams, and also observed the damage in previous study also. So here, ductility index also considered based on different types of failure modes. So types one, diagonal compression failure. In this case, we proposed ductility index 1.75. And type two sliding and diagonal cracking failure, in this case, 1.27. And type three wall flexure failure, in this case, we considered 1.75. And type four column punching and joint sliding failure, this is, in this case, ductility index is proposed 1.27. And this slide shows the relationship between beta index and conductance ratio with the ductility index. And this is the final slide. So this research, this chapter is proposed based on several experiments in Tohoku University and also experiment in HBRI. And also there were several discussions in Tohoku University and also in Dhaka. And thank you very much for your patience hearing.